An excerpt from Mama Bear by Danielle Ackley-McPhail. Something wasn't right. Except lately, a lot wasn't right. Made it hard to tell if this was something new or just the same old shit picking at her nerves. Suzanne Cosane, Fey exile and founding member of the Wild Hunt MC, downshifted and let up on the throttle as she approached the intersection. Her half-human husband, Lance, slowed to a stop next to her. She heard his whiskey-rich voice murmur from her helmet speaker. You doing okay, babe? She nodded as she opened up the throttle again, though she expected it was a lie. A white one, but still a lie. He didn't push her as he took position to her right and just behind her, letting her take front door. Good thing, because she hadn't a clue what to say. She felt wired, poised for a fight. Half the time protective, though she had no clue of what. The other half, 20 kinds of pissed off. One moment jubilant, the next melancholy. Life had become one constant emotional barrage. Her skin felt too tight, and her nerves buzzed with energy. Every smell was amped up, and nothing tasted right. Was it her curse, or had something else come along to screw with her? Still, the sun felt amazing, and the wind in her face cleared the fog she'd woken up in. Swerving around a road gator, remnants left by some trucker's blowout, she gunned it and took off down the empty stretch of road, her silver blonde hair whipping around her bare shoulders and leather halter top. Lance's laughter filled her headspace, lightening her mood. He drew up next to her, then pushed to pass. You're on, he crowed, speaking into his mic a bit louder to be heard over the engines as he revved his knucklehead. More than ready to play, Suzanne opened the throttle on her Harley Softail even further. As they raced down the backcountry road, Lance's thick, segmented ponytail lashing behind him, Suzanne suddenly sensed a mischief of a fey sort. She didn't slow down, but she did let her otherworldly senses play out, scanning the area around them. She laughed abruptly. Looks like your friend is looking to get back a bit of his own, she said into her mic as she brought all her attention back to the road. The ride had begun to get rougher. Wrinkles in the asphalt. An increase in potholes. A network of cracks like you'd find in the deep desert. She wasn't worried. She and Lance both had ride bells hanging off their bikes, spelled with protections against road gremlins. Lance growled in annoyance, and Suzanne felt the build-up as he drew power until his shoulder fins unfurled through the slits in his jacket and tendrils of energy arched from his back. She heard him call out with his thoughts as he let his iridescent white wings flare. Cut it out, smear, he growled, addressing the embodiment of the road. Every road. The little bugger held something of a grudge against the Wild Hunt, the club's leader in particular. That would be Lance. Not today. The road conditions just continued to get rougher, and the breeze carried the sound of grumbling just low enough that Suzanne couldn't make out the words. The tone carried loud and clear, though, as her front wheel jittered to the side, slipping on the edge of a tar snake she could have sworn hadn't been there a moment before. Suzanne managed to straighten the Softail out, but her patience waned. Not finding the situation funny anymore, she also started drawing power. Her fins unfurled with a snap until energy crackled across her back, in what she knew were lavender and blue wings, with rosy accents that deepened to red and black when her curse got the better of her. From the snap of the current, she expected those hues were darkening. Ever since she'd taken revenge on a murder of redcaps, her nature had grown more complicated. Volatile. Or, as Lance liked to put it, bloodthirsty. Literally. She'd ended the redcaps who'd attacked her, but in the fight had somehow claimed the leader's cap for her own. At the time, she hadn't known the nature of the beastie. The creature she slew wasn't the redcap. The hat was. A parasitic fey that corrupted the nature of whatever host it glommed onto. Or tried to, anyway. She'd come under a constant barrage of emotional assault ever since, sly and subtle one moment, hitting her like a sledgehammer the next. Suzanne was giving it the fight of her life until she found a way to break free. Just, sometimes, she lost ground. Emotions were Lance's strength. He'd spent most of his life as an empath with no access to his mage talent. Suzanne, on the other hand, had been emotionally repressed right up until the day she'd broken free from her father's control and fled to the mortal realm. Even thinking about it sent a red haze over her vision. The air grew heavy with tension, and the sunlight took on hard edge. Pissed at how everyone seemed to think they could mess with her life, she summoned a mage bolt. This has been an excerpt from Mama Bear, which will be printing in Badass Moms, edited by Mary Fan, and published by Crazy 8 Press. Look for it in July 2020.